in itself leads to frustration. I show you some other frustration. Every business person I've met have complained about their employees. They come to work late and they go early. And any time they go on break, it's like they've gone to smoke in their hand. Because somebody can come to the office fine. Then during break, when he comes, he begins to misbehave. This is the frustration of an employer of labor. To your subcontractors, who knows what they do with their time, but they sure can charge for their time. Subcontractors will slow you down because the more days they get to work, the more money for them. Frustration of a business person. Your suppliers, this is another thing. You say, sir, I will supply first thing in the morning. 1 week you are still pursuing them to supply that thing and you need to deliver on the job. Frustrations of an entrepreneur. Then how about your customers? Have you ever been this? You are just waiting, your customer is talking, you've talked for one hour to convince him. He comes the next time again, coming for 1 hour. You'll be asking, this man, can't he get brain at all? Why can't he make up his mind? So every day you go to work, there's frustration. Frustration. People, every entrepreneur's nemesis. And without people, you cannot grow. So at the heat of it all are people who work for you. Have you ever had yourself say the following things? By the time I tell them to do this, I could have done it 20 times myself. Who has this type of frustration? Sometimes say, waiting are they employ these people for? I could have done it based on, or you've heard yourself, it's like nobody is hearing me in this office. I'm just talking, nobody is hearing me. Why is it that nobody is doing what I asked them to do? Who has that frustration there? Then I think you are in the right place. You have to know this, working with people can bring great joy or monumental frustration. And so it is with employers and their people. So why this? Let's start from who is an entrepreneur and who he isn't. Who are you? What are you supposed as an entrepreneur? Who are you? Because if you don't understand who you are, it will be difficult for you to position yourself well. So let's look at some of the things that make you who you are, that put you in the position where you are. Few entrepreneurs are prepared to use other people to get results. Why? Because they are fixated on getting the results themselves. It's a natural, how will I say it, virus that every person starting business has to go through. You want to do everything by yourself. You know, because if the vision is yours, it's burning inside of you. So you want to do everything yourself. You want to achieve the result. You know, sometimes you will send somebody to do something. You will say, come, give me that thing. Let me go and do it myself. Does it happen to you? That's the problem. That's where it starts. In other words, most entrepreneurs are not business people. Most entrepreneurs are not the business people they need to be. But they are technicians that are suffering from what is called entrepreneurial seizure. And you will see the explanation will come. Question, what are you doing? What were you doing before you became an entrepreneur? Most entrepreneurs think that because they know how to do the technical work, they are automatically prepared to create a business that does that type of work. This is the greatest error, the greatest fallacy that you will ever meet in the corporate world. Not because you know the technical part means that you can run that business. Earlier on in the year, I thought about contractors, can't remember the name of which I really dealt with this. Because you are a trained engineer does not mean you can run an engineering firm. No, it doesn't mean that. It doesn't follow that you will do well. It doesn't mean that you will do well in that. So you need to create a system that works for you. You need to change, first of all, in the mindset. Because the day you open a law firm, and the day you open a hospital, you are no longer a doctor, a lawyer. You are an entrepreneur. If you haven't heard me teach this yet today, because if you still go with that doctor's mentality, you will be doing everything and one day you will break down. You are a business person. That office is a going concern. And that office needs to produce profits. And people need to help you to do that. Because you will open the hospital and you are, I've seen a doctor one day, I saw him sweating. I said, which kind of money are you? You know, he will come out, he will see patients, he will call the patients. He has three doctors there, but he will call patients and he's sweating. And at the end of the day, I ask him, these doctors are earning more money than you. You are still doing everything because you are no longer see, you have not accepted the fact that you are an entrepreneur, no longer a doctor. And also, people go into business for the wrong reasons. You see people going to, I don't tire with this, my God, let me go and try myself. Let me go and try my luck. Business is not what you enter into because you are tired of your boss or tired. I keep telling people, entrepreneurship is a profession. If business is what you enter into because you have a solution to somebody's problem. You are solving a particular problem. You have a solution. And that solution is the value added. And let me talk about value added. All of us can produce a phone. So when you want to start your own phone company, what is the value added that will make us leave Samsung and come to you? What are you offering that other people are not offering? The first market penetration strategy you should have is that I have something that will make your life easier. I have something that will make your life easier. I have something that others are not giving. That is the right to enter the marketplace. So if you do not have that right, please go and work for somebody because you're just going to mess up. An entrepreneur is someone that is offering solution, not someone that is in business. And some people just enter it. And when you enter into that kind of business, because you are not prepared mentally, you will not get in there, and what you are doing all the work. And you end up like this man. Most entrepreneurs imagine that once they become their own boss, they will be free to do whatever they wanted to do and take the money home. Yes, the money is coming. So they go into business and immediately they will dive into it, doing it, busy like that guy. Until one day, and what is that one day? Until one day they realize that maybe or maybe not, that they are the ones doing all the work. If you do not realize it, you have staff. And you are the one doing all the work, and the staff are just enjoying. And they will just leave you down. If you have that mentality that you want to do it all the time, you want to get it done well, what happens is that your staff will thank you for it. You are doing all the work. Then you will end up doing everything that you know how to, plus the ones that you do not know how to, frustration begins to set in. And that is what is called entrepreneurial seizure. And when you employ someone and there's no clear-cut process or there's no system in place for him to work, what happens is that, do you know that you can employ a very smart person? Very smart person. And the person begins to work for you, but the person does not have the opportunity to use their brain. They become redundant. So what they do is now they begin to look for another job, and they will do everything that you say. For me, with my staff, I tell them, you are here to make my life better. You are here to bring that solution. I'm not going to give you solution. I expect you to tell me, this is our problem, how can we solve it? I didn't bring you here so that I'll be the one that, you know, sometimes you will be the one to write letter. How can I be writing letter? What do I have people for? How can I be the one, when we discuss in meetings and discuss, I've seen a CEO, we finish meeting, he's the one that will still write the minutes. I say, look, wait, I need this. So what are you doing? What are they doing? See, the brain of every human being needs constant pressure. If you leave your brain redundant, your output will begin to become redundant. You must be reading something. You must be adding something. And you see, there's something about the brain. The more you use it, the more it functions for you. So you see people in business development, the first time they come, because that's my area of strength. The first time we started, and I remember when I was working and my executive director came and he said, this is what we want to achieve. So by tomorrow, I want suggestions. We were greenhorns. I said, well, how do we get this kind of idea? You under that pressure, we started calling and asking questions, where can we get this information? The knowledge I have about business development, I got it under pressure. Because that man doesn't play with you, he can sack you on the spot. How can you just sack job one month they sack you? What will you tell them after you've done testimony in church? Do you understand? So it is that pressure that will bring it out. So always be under pressure. People don't like issues. No. This is my client. Yeah, this pressure is wala is too much. Then you are not ready for the big leagues. Because it's pressure that we make. I've had a client put me under pressure. I don't like that Aba road. I've had a client put me under pressure. I don't even like to go to Aba. I had to go there. I didn't finish. I slept over. I slept the 2-3 days in a town I didn't really like. But do you know that the love for Aba that I have now, the love developed that period because I saw the potential of what they can do. And it was pressure that took me there. And what I went there, my interest was in other things. By the time I entered there, my interest was in other things that I was looking for. Not even what took me there. What am I saying? Pressure brings out opportunities for you. Because you will never think of the things that you will normally think of. You will never, if you are under pressure, you are ready to do anything. You are ready to deliver. You are ready to deliver at all costs. So please, when you have that pressure, it's God sent. Because without pressing, except a wheat of corn falls down and dies, he abides alone. Everything in life and your business, your everything must go through that process. Death, burial, and resurrection. You can be doing well, very well, and that business will crash because God now wants to raise something else. If somebody here has lost the business, then it's time for you to start again. Because now there's wisdom. You will not want to fail. God allows some certain things. God gives us weaknesses. Allow some certain things to happen. Because that is the death and burial for you. But for some people, they pack it up. Say, so, I go look for work after I have a degree. But you don't understand that that is a process that you're going. God is allowing you to go through that process so that something better can come out. Something better can come out. Let me go back to my... Frustration begins to set in now because you are doing all the job by yourself. Let me still talk more on the brain. If you're a parent, make sure your children are engaged one way or another. They are engaged. Make sure they read one thing, they acquire something, the same thing. I think it was Monday that I was saying here, I said, look, when you get to work, hit the internet to try and see better ways of doing that thing. Explore knowledge. You know, it's when some people, is when they call you for a job, that's when you start researching. Research is part of the work. I tell people that it's not when you get to work and there's a spirit behind Facebook. When you just say, let me just, you sit down first thing in the morning, let me just check what's on Facebook. Sometimes 1 hour you have been there 1 hour before you realize. Even to read news, sometimes me, I open Punch. By the time I'm reading, you go to this, 1 hour has passed. And you are not able. What do you do? Whatever you are doing, you must be looking for better ways of doing it. And those things are right there on the internet. You must solve 2 hours. I told a guy, I was speaking to someone in my church. I said, come. If one was in the choir, one said he's an entrepreneur. I said, fine. I said, look, you have intentions of having your own songs. You have intentions of becoming a gospel artist. He said yes. So I said, what do you do? Because I've talked to him before. You must practice 4 hours every day. 4 hours every day. Some will practice 4 hours in the morning and 2 hours in the evening. Because success comes at a price. Success comes at a price. And you must do voice training. I had to research some things about choir, and I called him. I said, you've been singing, I've been singing in this choir. Have you done this? He said, no, Pastor Abner. I said, look, God didn't grace me with that. So I cannot waste my time and be drinking egg that maybe my voice will be better. That's all my area of strength. I said, do you know that you can, this is what you, have you gone to YouTube and listened to people that grew? So he gets to work, or I don't know, every day he takes 4 hours to learn about these things and to now practice them the best way. And I said, look, the same thing, you are an entrepreneur. I asked the other man, what do you do? I said, do you do what this man does? He said, no. I said, then how will you become successful? Success comes from being deliberate. Are you a pastor? How many people do you listen to every day? How many books do you read every day? How do you develop yourself on that every single day? Do you know that motivational speaking is an industry worth close to $5 billion. Do you know that? It's silent, you will not know. If you grow yourself, there are different levels. If you grow yourself and understand what it takes for you to become that kind of person. And all these things I'm saying will require you being able to effectively use people. And there are people that can help you achieve it. Don't be the kind of boss you don't want to try. Is it trust? Not trust. It's not trust to try to just give somebody a chance. In life, which one is? What is the person that you trust today? The person that you trust today, you gave that person a chance a while back. Staff will always misbehave. Human beings will always misbehave. But out of 10 that come and go, there might be 2. And you also need to position yourself in a way with certain things that can attract that staff and keep them. Use your staff. Use their brain. You did not bring them in. You did not partner with them so that you can have people around. You partner with them because of the talent that they have. And you have to find a way to develop that talent in them. And most of the time, it's having a system that works. And we say, since you are the one in charge, in this entrepreneurial season, you find out that you are the one signing all the checks, but all the money is going to other people. Has it happened to you before? It happened to many years. I'm not on salary. I have company. All the money goes to employees. You will see the money come, you see the money go. Yes, we are managing. Because as a vision, as the owner of the company, you want it to succeed. You want to pay your staff, you need it. But all the money is going to them and nothing is coming to you. So if you find yourself with this entrepreneurial season, then let us show you the right thing to do. It is called the secret, the people's law. And what is the people's law? As we get into it, the critical information is without people, you don't own a business, you own a job. You are just a self-employed. Without people and fully engaging them, you say you're a business person, but no, you just have a job because you are working. You might be working for yourself, but you are working because people are not helping you. One person, you are just getting the benefit of one person. You have not learned how to get the benefit of everybody. And this is the worst job you can have in the world. Without people, you are forced to do it all by yourself. You try to do more, but actually you get less done. You realize that in addition to doing the work, you also have to do the books, you have to do the accounting, you have to do the estimation, you have to do the selling, you have to do the planning, you have to do the buying, ordering, and pickup. Because you see, say, these are my people, yeah, I don't know why I'm paying, all of them are mad people. So you end up doing everything. And in a small business like that, the labor is endless. But with people helping you, things can improve dramatically if truly you understand how to engage people. The problem is in knowing how to engage people in the work you need them to do. And how do you do that? When you learn to replace yourself with other people, you have to learn to replace yourself with other people as time goes on. People trained in the system, then your business can truly begin to grow. Because now the business the system supports growth and supports learning. People are actually your greatest asset and not your greatest liability. is because there's no system in place, which is what I'm trying to show you. People's law says that each time you add a new person to your business, each time you add a new person to your business using an intelligent turnkey system, which is a system that works, you can expand your reach. And you can expand your reach almost infinitely. What am I saying? If all of us here, you can look at the experience of all of us here. The experience of all of us here. If put together, we can achieve more than one person coming and saying, I am the boss. One person coming and saying, I am this, I am that. And you are doing the work. Learn to leverage on other people. Learn to leverage on other people. People are to entrepreneur what a record is to a successful musician. Turnkey, this word turnkey comes from, remember when we used to have turntable? We used to have, turntable, we have those round CDs, disc. What were they called? Labels, we used to call them labels, the turnkey. That you put it and it keeps playing. So people are to entrepreneurs what a record is to a successful musician. The record or song can be played in million places at the same time, regardless of where the musician is. Your business, it says, with the help of people, the musician creates quality recordings that faithfully replicates his unique talent. And then make sure it is marketed, distributed, and revenue is managed. What am I saying here? You have a gift. You have an idea. You have that solution that the world needs. That is why you started the business. So you must be able to create a system that business continues to work whether you are there or not. Until you are able to create a system, until you are able to create a system where whether you are there or not, the business is going, it becomes difficult. Only you will now be making it work. So look at a musician, we play. All of us have music, we buy a CD. But the musician doesn't have to play for you every time. When you play music in your car, the musician is not there. But the musician, every time you buy a CD, he's getting profit from it. Because he has already developed a system that works for him. And he has people that are recording, he has people that are surviving from his talent. So that idea that made you start that business is the talent God has given to you. And so everybody that is connected to you and that business will be profiting because God gave you an idea. And so you have to develop a system that is unique, a system that is unique to your talent, and make sure that thing can be marketed, distributed, and you get revenue from it, whether you are there or not, like every musician that you need. So you need to create a special way of doing everything that needs to be done. Because now we're getting into the nitty-gritty of things. There must be a special way. There must be a unique way. There must be one way of doing everything that needs to be done in your business. What did I say? Special way, unique way, and this thing can be replicated. Success in business is being able to replicate. If you do something and you don't know what made you successful, that is a fluke. You must know, success comes by repeated performance. Repeated performance is that you already have that special system. And that special system is what you can replicate. And when you replicate it, you can market it, you can distribute it, and you can now manage the revenue. And in all of this, you might or might not be there. So successful people need to create effective ways of doing business by providing a turnkey solution to their customers' problem. A system solution that really works. What it does is that it creates the ability for your business to produce income without you having to go to work every day. The best way to explain this further is what? The franchise business. As a franchisee, what are you going to do? The model is already there. When you see Kilimanjaro, or you see Mr. Beats, or you see Chicken Republic, it's not the owners that are doing it now. They are franchisees that take the franchise. The owner of the product will even locate, because I remember during the promise, who I'm close to, I know how they do, and I asked, he came to one of our ICBEC Make in Nigeria programs, and he told us how it works, he showed us how it works. So what happens is that they will locate the place. They will show you the location where it can work. They will give you the recipe. You cannot change the recipe. You cannot change anything. The taste is the same. The customer care is the same. The feeling is the same. All you just need to do is that the ownership is what is different. So you have paid the franchisor his money, and now as a franchisee, you are making his money and he's making his own money, and the system is not shaking in any way. So the same thing is to be replicated in every area of your business. So you started your business, you were everything in that business, right? You started your business. So as the business is growing, you will employ someone that will be a marketer. Anytime you are going out, you go out with the person. And the person is seeing how. They're seeing how you do it. The person is seeing how you became successful in the first place. Because there's a level of success you will attain before you will begin to employ people. So let's just use this as an analogy. You get the marketing person. He's going out with you. As he's meeting people, you are teaching him certain things. He's understanding the business more. And he's able to now, once in a while, because it's about training, it takes a bit of a while for you to be able to do that. So you send him sometimes and he will go, and he's becoming strong in that. He's beginning to learn the secrets of marketing that made you successful. So what you now do is what? You will now get to a point that you use it more. Then you go for opening of the door, if it's your contact, or you will go to close it, or the business, depending on the kind of business you do. Then when you see that the man is beginning to perform, then you will now change him, you will now change some certain things. Because marketing now is no longer you employ somebody, you pay. After a while, that thing that he's sourcing for, he begins to have some form of commission different from his salary. But he has to prove himself in that way. So more or less, you have an indirect partner. Because that is how it works. And when he comes, and you are using him that much, after a while, you get somebody that you are attached to him. After all, marketing is male and female that you use to send out. So you get somebody that will attach to him, so that there is always somebody in the office one day he decides to leave. So what it means that you've been able to achieve a certain level of stability in that area. Now the job is taking you out of town, you are going for meetings, you are going for things, so you need an office manager that can coordinate all these things and put them together. What that means now is that you will get someone. When you come to the office, the person is not far from you. Okay, do this one. And you realize, because if the back end is not taken care of, you cannot supply the people that are out there. So Gradually, you are training people, and you are training people to take over from you, so that you can now step back. And when you step back, now you choose which aspect of the business that you do. Business development is the number one function of every CEO. When you step back from the business, you can now critically analyze the business and see where the faults are. Because if you do not do that, you are inside, you are working, you are not able to see the business, how it functions. So now you have meetings. You have two key people that are doing that work. As the business is growing, there are certain aspects of the business you bring in someone, you train them. That is how you replace yourself. You must replace yourself with people that you trust. But we say that we're in a system of where people, employees are not trustworthy. You say all those things. But nothing ventured, nothing gained. There are some good employees that are still there. Gradually train them. When people come and they see you are the only one, that's why they call it one-man business. It can be a one-man business, but don't employ someone you are not able to tap their brain or tap whatever they are doing. If not, because it's a waste of time if you cannot use them. So, this is what people can do for you if your system of doing business can be faithfully replicated. What you're building is that you're building a structure that works, a structure that can run. In CEO's Forum, they'll tell you that can you leave your business for 3 months? If you say no, then they tell you that you don't have any system in place. Some people cannot leave their system for 1 week. Some pastors cannot even leave their church for 2 days. They'll tell you, well, I don't want to come back now. This church, the name don't change. It's true, because you have not built people. So the solution to all this is to create a system. Let's see how you create a system. You have to create a system, a unique way of doing business that you can do what? Teach people. That you can manage faithfully. That you can replicate consistently, like within McDonald's that I did the last, I think, 2 or 3 months ago. So you must have a system. And that system must be taught gradually. Gradually taught. You see, you trust in faces. You trust in levels. You just don't wake up one day and trust one person. You delegate responsibility in levels until you are able to understand that person. That person understands you. And that person can see his future. If your employee cannot see their future in what you are doing, it'll be difficult. They need to see their future. Even if they don't see their future, they need to be able to know, at least I learned something from them. I'm able to start. I used to have a travel and tours, events and tours. And the guy I taught, after a while, I needed to concentrate on other things, so that business went down. But the person I trained, that's what he does still today. And he can, everywhere he says, my birthday, he will bring something and say, thank you for showing me something. So you take away some because you are learning something. Any place that you go, you are not learning anything. All you are doing is go to the bank, you go and come. Go to this as a graduate, you go and come. Go to help yourself because you will become redundant. Your brain must be active, doing something. And without a system in place, you are left with, this is where the problem begins for you. when there's no system of doing, a systematic way of doing things, and you have not built people and taught them, because you have the strategy now, you know how it works. So if there's no way of handing it down to people, this is where people will now begin to do things on their own. And let me tell you, they are making mistakes with the integrity of their heart. They are actually doing the work the wrong way because they do not know the right way of doing it. Because you have not put standards in place. You have nothing in place to show them how to do it. They have not been taught. Because somebody is a graduate doesn't mean that he will come in and understand you. They have to be. Every company should have its own culture, its own way of doing things. What is that? What do you want? And let me tell you, if you cannot develop a blueprint, a system, procedures, how you want to run things, then maybe you are not ready for business yet, to be an entrepreneur yet. Because an entrepreneur must be able to know the different aspects of your business.
Yes.
What is your business? And when I ask people this, I get so frustrated when they don't, they will tell you one business. Okay. What are the different segments of this business? Let's use fashion. What are the different segments? They cannot effectively tell you the cost centers of that particular business. What kind of fashion business are you doing? Are you doing fashion that people bring their material, or you are selling your material with the sewing? So how do you procure materials? Where do you procure materials? Which country? How do you, have you considered doing wholesale in line with what you're doing? How do you get this material? Because the material is the bulk of what you're using. How do you source for the people that sew for you? How do you, must know every aspect of your business, because every aspect of your business cannot be faulty. So you can say, is this Togolese that I brought that are causing me problem? Can't I bring this Togolese and bring my brother to match, let them understand them? I don't know, it's not my business. But it's something that you can come up with ideas. So when I ask you, how come you are not making? I tell all the people listening to me, I say, look, don't bring any problem less than 10 million. I want you to be making 10. If you don't make 10 million, don't come to me. Because all this talk I'm talking, I'm talking so that you will come and tell me in 2019 you made 2 million, 5 million. I'm allergic to that kind of money. Do you understand what I'm saying? And the only way you can understand is to know the different cost centers and know how to bring down this so that you can increase profit. So now, in those different areas is where you will now train people. So you have a staff. Yes, she can sew, but she is good in negotiating buying materials. And she's able to go into places you cannot. Because for one reason, maybe one uncle has is into that business, so she has that kind of knowledge. So when you want to employ now, you are looking for somebody, you know the skill set, you know the experience of somebody that can go and be buying materials for you. Then you can say, go to Aba, go to Cotonou, go to Lagos and buy for me, because they have the natural flair for it. And they already have experience for it. And your own is that you're spending 1 million on materials, to buy materials every month or every quarter. So my assignment to you now is to make sure you bring down that cost to 500,000, the same material, same quality. If you know how to waka that waka into those places, you can bring down the cost. So you might not be able to do it because you are sophisticated, you don't want the market to spoil your nails. I don't have a problem with that. But you can get someone that can go in there and get you this material. So when you are interviewing that person, you are interviewing based on the knowledge of what you want. So don't employ without knowing what you really want from people. It's not the degree now. It's not what they wrote on the CV that matters. It's what you want them to do. It's what they have flair for. So you realize that, this is my target. To bring down this cost of material is too much. Then you look at sewing. How can I produce faster? Same quality, produce faster. Then you do analysis of your tailors. What do I do with these tailors to make them produce faster? So that we can turn over. Our turnover will be more, and so we can make profit. Is somebody understanding me? Then how do we now market? Because you can't have a good thing and be silent. How do I get a girl that can sew? Because everybody must have dual function. And don't employ somebody that cannot do two or three things. It's a waste of money. So you use them more in the area of their strength, but they can, during downtime, because there's always downtime in everything, they can do other things. And you know what? They will love you for that because they are growing. They are growing. They are seeing themselves grow in areas that they never thought they will grow. They will. Who will not love that kind of job? Don't go and employ an office man with somebody that don't eat dog leg. You know, some people can't stay one place. You must be able to. Those that in the office are good, those that go out, and you must look at them and know how to be able to use them. So what are the cost centers that you need to? That is where you train people. And it might take you a long, long time, but you have a focus. You have a direction. This is what I want in this place. Why? Because you want that person to... You want to replicate yourself in that person, and you want to hands off that area so that you can become a CEO. So you have a marketing person that can take your materials. You have a marketing person that can do social media, that can put you there in Instagram, in Facebook, that can do all those things for you. She might or might not so, but she will push you. She will push you on the internet where you need to be. Because these are the things that you used to do for yourself. And guess what? The older you become, the harder it is to understand the social media thing. It's just like me, I want to compete with Banji. How will I start now? From where? You understand? It comes with the age and time. You need to understand where you are, what you have, and how to use it. So now, when you come to, you can now stroll into the office by 10 o'clock. And you can now look, they are having this thing in the Chamber of Commerce. You can now have money to go and pay for Chamber of Commerce. You now have money to begin to do all those things that CEOs do. You know why? Because in the morning, every Monday, they will come and tell you how they want to make the money for you. Every Friday, they will come and tell you how they have made the money for you. So that Monday, 10 o'clock, you are playing golf in the Air Force Base. That's how it works. It's not rocket science. It's not rocket science. That's how it works. Because you have replicated yourself in these people. You have trained them in these people. And as you're training, you are attaching. You're training, you are attaching. You're training, you are attaching. So the system It's never broken. So the donkey now that we're talking about is the gift, the talent God has given to you. And that you're able to walk. And once you are walking this thing, you have people that will be walking it for you. So after a while, you relax. And the system works for you. So you can, after a while, decide to go and start another business. And grow it like you've grown this one. And that one too, after a while, will begin to walk. And before you know it, so that before you are 65, you have businesses that are running for you. And all you just, when you retire, you know that the money is there. Please, nobody here should retire hoping on their children. Leave them, let them enjoy their life. All this burden of let me send to father, let me send to mother. Let's do something. Do some, because if you are able to make 50 million and put it in the account, fix it or buy treasury bills. 50 million, depending on the rate, assuming it's 12%, you fix it for 1 year, it will give you 6 million. They will credit 6 million automatically to your account. 6 million are when you've retired. What are you eating, you and your wife? You can't even eat because the teeth is not strong. Do you understand? So when your children bring, you even pay school fees for something. Don't worry, this one I will pay. Do you understand? Not the time that your children will call you once your children see your call, their heart has. It shouldn't be so. Because we must prepare for our retirement. We must. And the opportunities are there. Okay, where am I? So, without building such systems, anarchy, confusion, mistakes after mistakes, and these people are actually trying to help you, is because there's no system in place. And this is how the problem started in the first place. People doing what they perceive they needed to do, regardless of what you want. You know why? They don't know what you want. So they feel that they can. They don't understand the business, so they feel they can help you because you have not put any system in place. People left to their own devices with no regard for the cost of their behavior. This is the thing. You must clearly explain to your staff that any misbehavior costs money. It costs money. And if they don't begin to see that whatever they do will have a ripple effect on the bottom line of the business, because you don't tell them, you don't teach them, they are not involved in the processes that make the company what it is. So they will behave because they will misbehave, not even knowing that they are misbehaving. That misbehavior of misbehavior can be as simple as receiving a phone call and be nasty to the person, and that is 10 million naira gone down the line. But if they realize that customer care is part of what will bring something into the company that pays their salary, I believe that they will understand that they are part of the system in producing. CEOs, try to hide many things. What are you hiding? These people are stakeholders of some kind in your business. So we must at all times let them know. You can't leave people to do things. There must be processes, procedures on what to happen, and there's training, practical training on what is happening. We're going to some meetings. Bring somebody to see how these things are done. Bring somebody. One guy came to the chamber, I think he was the manager, and he kept meeting them. It's not as if they ask him to say anything or do any presentation. This guy was shaking. He was shaking. A manager. He was shaking. Even when they say introduce yourself or introduce you, he was shaking. Because the people he's seen there, he has never seen them before. He only hears about them, but he has never seen them. So he's shaking because he's not exposed. Sometimes let him follow you now. You just let him see how it's done. So that the day you are not there, he too will stand and talk like you. Anything they ask him there, he will not have the confidence to speak on your behalf. So you must groom people in that way. Leaving them to their devices would make you be bleeding every day, and one day the company will fold up. Business without systems, they are going to crash. No way. They are, you see this one. Their colleague is down. They don't understand how they will take him up. They have no clue of what to do because there's no system in place. Dangers of not having system. The people law is unforgiving. It's unforgiving. If you do not develop a system that works as a turnkey, it's unforgiving. That business will crash. Without a systematic way of doing business, people are often, more often, a liability than an asset. Because they don't know what to do. People's law say without a specific system of doing business, without a specific system of recruiting, now I've taught you how to recruit and hire and train people to use that system and to create and manage and improve that system, your business will fizzle out after a while. It will fizzle out after a while. Don't play games with your source of livelihood. Do not. But this is what business people do. You see that phobia of, you don't want to invest in somebody, they will not come and go. That limits us from training people to become. It's a two-way thing. Everybody is watching. If they cannot see certain things, and sometimes employers are not sincere in some certain things. But when you are sincere and that person can see his future to an extent, the person will stay. Look at companies every day. They still have staff. They still have staff that have been in one company 20 years. So, don't let the devil tell you that human beings are so deep. In fact, the more you help them, the more you... If you help them because you are doing all the work, you are not developing, they are not enjoying the work. So when they leave, you become frustrated. Do not play with your source of livelihood. People's law says that you can't effectively delegate your responsibility unless you have something specific to delegate. What are you delegating? Okay, we come to the office and say, okay, today we'll go marketing. You go like this, you this. What are you delegating? It's not when you come. The day you don't come, everybody's in the office doing nothing. Everybody must have their role, and you are trained. See, the work of a CEO is training. Even in the meetings, you are giving them pep talk and you are encouraging them, you can do it, this is what we want to achieve. Put the vision before them all the time. You must have something to delegate. If not, you cannot delegate. And that something specific is what? A way of doing business that works. And how do we know that way of doing business? You! Before they came, you, before Abraham was, Jesus, before Abraham, Jesus was. So Jesus knew about creation. So when he came, he was not coming to a place he did not know. He was there at creation. It is you that will develop it. You have tried it. If you have to document your successes, your procedures, that lead to that success, do it. And so you replicate it in someone, and that becomes a system. That becomes, how did you do your market? Do you know, if you go to marketing meetings, they are talking strategy, how to enter company, how did you do it? This one is saying, this is how I, they are learning procedures and behaviors. And that's when you get the right habit to do the work. So it's in discussing these things. How did you do it? That first contract you did, how did you do it? What are the things you did that were successful? That is what you need to. This is what becomes a system. So create a system that works so that when you die, your family will still be enjoying because you created a system. So if your son decides, I don't want to do this line of business, it's okay. The business doesn't have to die. But because it's your son, he will continue to have dividend as a director, but he's not running the business. So the business, don't start a business that should be least should be 200 years you live, except Jesus comes before them. Why? Because there's a system in place. We know our success is not a fluke. Our success is deliberate. Success is deliberate. Yes. Success is because you are doing some certain things right. It's not because you just prayed in church one day and something happened. Yes, God gives us opportunities every day, but we abuse those opportunities. Every contract is a learning field, is a learning ground for something else to come. And that is what you teach your employees. That is what you and that is what you train them with. And before you know it, they become one with you and the company is growing. Thank you very much.